Hello dear friends. We continue with the second video of still loading. In this video, I just want to talk about some fundamentals about the loading still products. Okay. So I will just proceed with the photos. Okay. For the damaging. If the coil is bigger than 15 metric ton, if it is more than 15 metric ton, they just put 3 damage layers. Okay. If it is less than 15 metric ton, generally they put only 2. Just one in the forward part and the one in the aft part, not in the middle. But sometimes they put also 3 if it is less than 15. But if it is more than 15 ton, okay, they should put 3 damages. So you see here like this. If any some close pictures I want to show, just a moment. And when they are putting this damage, one of the important thing is, just a moment, if any. So you see this one, this the last damage is very close. So I just draw here, just a moment. For example, this is my coil. Okay, I am looking from the top. They just put damage one in the middle, in the down. But the edge damages not very close the edge of the coil. This is wrong. Okay, here if they put very close to the end, this is wrong. How they should put? They just put some little gap here, like this. Has to be some distance. Okay, not very close to the end. Okay, this is one of the thing. If my coil is more than 15, okay, 3 damage. But if it is less than 15 ton, okay, 2 damage is enough. One of the important thing is this one. The other important thing is this damage when they put to the ship side, it must not move. Okay. Okay, this cargo hold is flat. But for example, if you are loading in a bulk carrier vessel, I just draw again. This is your tank top. This is your double bottom hopper, correct? The vessel is coming like this. And then you put your coils here on the tank top. Like this it is going. They just supply here. They just feed here with some damages, okay? Normally, what they should do? This damage on the sides, I will show you here, I think the first picture. Here. Must be nailed each of them. Okay. They should nail. If they nail, it will be fixed. When they put the steel coil here, this damage cannot lean. Okay. By the rolling, by the vibration, it will not move normally. But generally they are not making like this. And if your vessel is a bulk carrier vessel, I draw again. Okay, this is the hopper. This is the tank top. They just put the coil, the corner coils here. Okay, I just draw the other side also. For example, like this. Okay. And this is my coils. I just put here. Put here, and here, for example. When they put the damage here, must be fixed, okay. But they are not nailing each of them. They are not nailing, so they just put here, but you should check actually. Not only the side. For example, if you are loading steel slabs, for For example, if you are loading steel slabs like this here, and this is the next slab here, for example, okay, this is the top surface. So you already load several layers, and this is the top layer with the slabs. Okay, and here if they put some dunnage, for example, between the slabs, steel slabs, it must not move also. So what is important with these steel cargo products, if they make the dunnage, it must not move. Also this small triangle parts here, you see? This one. We just proceed the next picture, another. If have, I show you. This one. So you see these triangle pieces here must not move also. So what they are doing actually for the this hot rolled coils, when they are loading, they are making like this. Okay, so I have already show you one of the picture, I think. Where is it? Just check. Pardon. You see here. This one. Şimdi they just lay all the dunnage, three layer for the each row. They just put, and then they also put the triangle before. Then what is the problem here? For the hot rolled coils, actually it is not very big problem because they just put the cargo on the tank top in the middle of the hold with the bulldozer, with the forklift, they just bring here one by one. But what is important for this hot rolled coils, these products are very strong, okay, cannot be damaged. But for the cold rolled coils, the packing is sensitive, okay. So for example, what is the problem here? I am just drawing here. Okay. Şimdi, this is the first tonnage here. This is the second tonnage. Okay. And this is the third tonnage here. I have already one coil there. Okay. Like this. So I will put the other coil here. So these triangle pieces I just draw here. If they put one of the triangle pieces here, one of the triangle pieces here also, but it is same, the same distance from the other coil. But for example, the middle one, just for example, which one is the different is not important. Maybe this one forward, this one forward, or this one forward. Sometimes two forward, one aft, no problem. But if this distance, okay, for example 1 meter, this distance 1 meter, for example, just for example. But this is much more close here, you see. For example 90 centimeter. So this is 10 centimeter inside, okay. So when I put the cold rolled coil here, okay, this one not damage the packing, not only the packing, but also it will damage the cargo inside, okay. This is important. It will, how, this is wooden, okay, it is coil, how it will damage, it will make scratch. This cold rolled coils is very expensive and a final product. Okay, they are just making refrigerator, car, something. They will not fabricate it again. So it's sensitive cargo. This is very, very important. All of these triangles must be the same level, same distance with the next one. Okay, very, very important. If one of it is forward, all the weight of the coil from the corner, I just draw here. This is my coil, okay, this is the dunnage. If this triangle part is inside like this, close from the other ones, so this corner will damage the packing, okay. This is very, very important, another thing, okay. And then we just continue. Evet. Okay. For the lashing, I just want to talk about the lashing. Bakayım şurada. Here. You see, şimdi for example in these coils, how they make? You see one belt here and other one. You see this fixing parts. These are two. So what is the rule? Okay, what I told you for this lashing inside the cargo hold, what is the purpose? The purpose is just prevent the initial movement. So if your coils are less than 15 metric ton, only one strap. I just erase just a moment. Pardon. If your coils less than 15 ton, only one strap is enough. But if your coils more than 15 ton, you see they make two. All of them should be two. If they make here two. If they make other side two, must be two. Okay. This is also another thing. But 3, 4, 5, okay, forget this one, no need. Okay. This is also another important thing. Yes. The danage should not be moved. Okay. Yes. Şimdi one of the other thing what I want to speak about is this one. For example, pardon, I take this one. Bunları anlattık. Cold rolled'lar, evet. When you are loading the cargo, you see, for example, these coils are big coils. More than one human height, okay. Maybe these are 2 meter diameter coils. What is important? For example, when they are loading. Yani normally, şimdi I will just enter the initial, I will make an entrance for the how you will prepare the plans for this one. Okay. In this video, I will not explain, but I just want to enter the topic. Okay, about this one. For example, if they told you, okay. You will load steel coils, you are on the vessel, just make us a calculation, or they just send you, for example, they already attend some supercargo, and the supercargo already prepare one stowage plan, and the company sent the vessel, the already prepared stowage plan, and ask you if it is okay or not. What should you consider? Okay, one of the important thing is this one. Yeah, this is actually twin deck different project cargo vessel, but what I want to tell you, you know, here some vertical ladders. Just a moment, I just check if I can find any picture, just a moment. Because it is important thing actually, you know, very important thing. Yes, here. Açamıyormuş. Just a moment. I just close this one. Yeah, I think I have some problem with the picture manager. Okay, I will open this one another program. Just a moment. Here. Şimdi what I want to tell you, you see here, pardon. Ne oldu be? Yes. You see, this is a typical bulk carrier. For example, this is forward traverse corrugate. Anyway, you know what is important. Okay, here they will put what I told you before. What is the general rule? If your coils are more than 15 ton, you can make two layer. If it is less than 15 ton, okay, three layer. But this is just a general rule. Okay, you should check your tank top strength. But anyway, for any reason, not more than 4 tier. Okay, in one row, only 4 tier. Maximum 3 tier, not 4, 5. Okay, forget this one. For the steel coils. But what is the important? They just send you the stowage plan. For example, you see here is a platform for the vertical ladder. You just go here, go to platform, and then go from there. This is lower platform, this is upper platform, and then you just go to cross deck. So some of the vessel, these lower platforms are very down. Okay, for example, in this location. So when they send you the stowage plan, you should also consider this one. What should you consider? If your lower platforms are very low, very close the tank top. For example, you just put another coil here and you will put the second coil, the second tier. So one coil here and one coil here, but the third coil maybe you cannot put. Okay, it is important thing. So one of the important thing you should consider also this one. So from this corrugate, you should have some distance between the, for example, I just draw here like this. Dur bakayım, pardon. Böyle yandan resim var mı hiç? Just open. Açıyor mu? Yok. Şöyle atalım. Okay, I open with this one again. You see, here is the one of the platform. For example, this platform not here, maybe very close to here. It is here, somewhere here. So, what is the distance from the corrugate, the connection with the tank top. Maybe you should keep some distance from there, okay? So you will not put the, you know, I show you one of the document from the IMO. The distance between the coils is 10 to 15 centimeter something. But here you should consider this one. If your coils are very big, some of the coils, okay, for example, I am looking the coil from the side, okay. Some of the coils are long, but the diameter is small, okay. This is the inner hole, okay. I am just looking a coil from the side. Some of the coils, the length is small, but the diameter is big. Okay. Like this. This is the inner hole. Some of the coils very thin also. Very thin, but diameter is very big. Okay. So, but for example, all the weight is same. For example, both all of them 25 ton. But this diameters and the size are different. So if you are loading these coils, it will make problem. Or maybe you have to shift. For example, the small diameters you put here, and when you put the second tier, not reach this level, and then the diameter big ones you put the next row. Anyway, you have to adjust, you have to consider this one also. Okay. And when you are making the storage plan, I just close this one. I just erase. When you are making storage plan, okay, Even if cold rolled or hot rolled, not important. Okay. This one. Ne oldu be? Allah Allah. Allah Allah. Yeah, I have just some problem, I think. This picture manager. Why like this? This one. Anyway, I don't know this one. I just make like this. Okay. I just shift again. Yeah, these are cold rolled. How I understand cold rolled from the packing. It is protected with the packing. Anyway. What is the important thing? Şimdi when you are making stowage plan, actually for this vessel it is a box shape cargo hold. It is very very easy actually. But it is a bulk carrier something. Anyway. What is the important thing? One, some of the golden rules. Okay. The first thing here is hop gitti. Just a moment. Kim var mı kaldı mı başka? Anyway, I show from there. In here, the heavy coils should be on the down. The light coils should be on the top. And the big size coils should be on the down. Small size, small diameter coils should be on the tank top. This is one of the rules. Okay. And the other important thing is the, for example, for the cold rolled coils, it is already finished cargo. They make the packing, everything they finish. But for the hot rolled coils, okay, the coil temperature is important also. It should be normally 50 or 55 Celsius degree, okay. Or less. For example, let's say 55 Celsius degree. If it is less than 55 Celsius degree, okay, no problem. But it is more than 55 Celsius degree. You know, they are just producing this one. They just hot roll, rolling, strapping and put the stockpile. Wait on the stockpile for the cooling, okay. But sometimes, for any reason, okay, it is not important. Maybe they just expecting another vessel and they just want to send your vessel earlier. So before the coil is cooled down, they just bring the coils in very high temperatures. For example, 170, 150, 180, very very hot. When you are walking the coil, you can understand the you can feel the temperature is coming. You cannot make any silver nitrat test, any, even if you cannot touch, it is very very hot. This is very big problem. Why it is big problem? Because these coils, you have two options. If really you are in hurry, what is important thing? Maybe for example, if this coil is very hot, for example, just 170 Celsius degree, 170. If they put this coil on the down, okay, and then they put another coil to the top of it, so this, the down coil is hot and it is soft actually. So with the weight of the top coil, it will deform the down coil. Okay, this is one of the reason. The other reason is the cargo sieving. Your cargo is hot. When you put in the cargo hold, it will be humid water. So when you close, when you seal, it will start surface rust. Okay, it is also another point. But if in your clauses you have already surface rust. Okay, so what you can do with the surveyor or you know, laser thermometers, you can measure from the distance. So when they bring the the car, the very big truck, all the carry coils has to check one by one if any problem. If any very hot coil, cannot put on the down. Okay. All the hot coils should be put on the top. It is very important. Okay. Otherwise, especially maybe one of the another option. For example, this one in the corner is hot. Okay. Maybe you can accept. This is on the top. Okay, you can accept. It is no problem because it will not deform, but only the cargo surface become rusty. Okay. Because of the cargo seating when it is cool down. But if you put hot coil here or here and you put another heavy coil on top of it, it will change the shape of the down coil. Okay, it is important. They cannot load this one. Don't forget 55 or 50, maximum 55 Celsius degree. If it is more than Celsius, you don't allow them to load. Okay, this is also another list. So, for example, you see here is the underside, under deck area, cross deck here, this area. For example, if you are loading sensitive coils and you if you have any problem with the cargo hold rubber packings. So, for example, cold rolled coils. Okay, you just put underside of these cross decks, okay, protected area. And then in the middle, the hatch coming area, you put the, for example, not sensitive cargo, okay, the hot rolled coil, anything. Okay, this is also another thing. Okay, bunları söyledik. So, one of the another important thing is if you buy some laser meter, you know, işte 40 meters length also enough. No need the 180, 150 meter length laser meter, no need. Even if maximum 40 meter if you are not in the cap size, okay. Also a cap size cargo length is smaller. Anyway, 40 meter is enough for a bulk carrier. Any kind, any size, no problem. 40 meter. So if they send you a stowage plan, or sometimes it is very very rare, but they can ask you, you prepare a stowage plan for these cargo steel products. Actually, it happened to me. I will explain. I will tell you about my experience. Okay. And then you, it is very very, it will be very big advantage for you if you have a laser meter. So when you go inside the cargo hold, you can measure directly. It will be very very fast for you. Okay, every distance you can measure with it. It can make a square calculation, cubic volume calculation, everything it can make. Okay, just maybe you can ask company also. This one, it is important. And one of the other important thing is, okay, let's talk about this. For example, if they ask you to prepare cargo plan, okay. Şimdi first of all, you should ask them, okay. You must know this one. What you must know? One of the thing. What is the packing list? Okay. How many coils they want to load? How many coil? How many? What are the sizes of these coils? Okay, I have already explained to you that, for example, diameter 2 meter, length is 1.5 meter. Diameter, for example, 1.35 meter, length is 1.85 meter. How many pieces? What are the sizes? So you must know the packing list. This is the first. The second thing is, if you will discharge the cargo in the different ports, you must know the load list, okay. So which cargo, where will be discharged, okay. This is also another thing. The other thing, okay, packing list I told. And the other thing is, for example, how they will load the cargo, okay. This is very very important thing, okay. In the next, tomorrow, I am planning to make another video. I will easy enter to how you will prepare this stowage plan for the steel coil, for the reinforced bars, rebars, D-bars, bridge, everything. I will, the steel billets, how you will prepare the, what are the things you should be careful about it. I will explain one by one, but just a general idea, okay. You must know the packing list. Any kind of the steel product, no problem. What is the packing list? What are the sizes? Okay, you must know. What about the load list? Which cargo will discharge in which port? Okay, this is the first thing. The other thing, how they will load, how they will discharge the cargo. This is also important. For example, for the coil cargo, actually it is not important because it is a typical way. They just put a bobcat, bulldozer inside. They just put the cargo on the middle of the cargo, then bulldozer take it, transfer to corners. They just, okay, I just explain here like this. For example, this is my cargo hold, okay, tank top. I just drop the tank top. And this is my hatch coming area. Okay, I am just looking the cargo hold, pardon, from the top. Okay. I am a bird now. Okay, I am flying. Okay, helicopter view. What I mean, helicopter view. Okay, I am just, this is forward. This is aft. This is starboard. This is port. Okay. So, generally for the any kind of coil, how they are loading this one? With the bulldozer, they just make a one row here and the second row here. Okay. And the first tier, second tier, whatever. And then come to other side aft. Okay, first row, second row, they just also load here. And then with the bulldozer, they just load one by one the coils here, here, here, coming also from there, there, there. All of them they just load here. And then finish here also. And then come here. Correct. Then maybe, I don't know, yeah, two forward aft direction, two line, second line, third line, I don't know. And then this edge coming area is free. Finally, they just put one by one, they just start to complete these rows. Each row, each tier. Because by the shore crane or ship crane, they can directly load this area. This area is free. This is the way. But for the, for example, rebar in coil, wire rod in coil, deformed bar in coil, how they will load? Because these are maximum two row or three row, two tier, three tier. But for example, I just close all of this here, just a moment, pardon, I just want to show you one picture. If your cargo is high, for example, you are loading wire rod in coil, it will be 10, 11, 15 tier. So, what is the method? How they will load? It is very, very important. Why it is very, very important? I will explain to you. Here, for example. Bakayım, var mı burada? Yes. Gündüz gözüyle var mı? Pardon. Sorry, just a moment. My battery almost finished. I am very sorry. Yes. For example, here. I just erase this one. For example, this is wire loading coils. What is the method of loading is very important. You know why? I just show you. For example, this is. Gelsin bakayım. You see here. This is the cargo hold number one. It's the forward side of the vessel. So, how they will load this? For example, you have to make initial calculation. Okay, how many ton? For example, hold number one. How many ton cargo you will load? For example, let's say 5,000 metric ton. One of the coil, this wire rod, about 2 ton. So how many pieces? 2,500 pieces. So in one layer, how many pieces I will take? Let's say işte 170-180 pieces I will take. Okay, so 170 in one layer, each of them 2 tons. How many ton it may make? 300, let's say 350 ton. Okay, so how many metric ton totally I will load? 2,500. So if I calculate, just a moment. Şurada. 2,500 divided 350. So it will make 7 TR. It will make 7 TR here. So how they will load this 7 TR? So I have already explained to you the steel coils. They just load at first the edges. The hatch coming area they make clear. All the corners they finish and then they put the cargo with the short crane. Also for this cargo, it is same way. They will put some bobcat or some bulldozer or some any device. Okay. At first they will finish the corners, all the corners, and then hatch coming area. We just say it pull. They make just pull. Same like swimming pool. Okay. It will be. I just show like this. Okay. Just I draw here. Okay. For example, this is my cargo hold. Going like this. This is forward. This is aft. Okay. And then with the bobcat or anything, at first they just put all the coils here and then here. İşte 1 tier, 2 tier, 7 tier. Okay, until 7 tier they finish here and then come here underside they just put and then start normally not 7 tier they put in one time. Don't forget for this coils, wire rolling coil, D-bar in coil, what was the name? Which dibitch deformed bar in coil, yes. In coil cargo like this, they make two steps. Okay, don't forget two ships. Generally port make two ships. What is the two shift for the bobcat? They don't have unlimited bobcat. Whenever you want, they don't. You cannot tell them. Okay, give me one bobcat or one bulldozer, anything, one machine inside the cargo. Only you have two chance. In one chance, they put the tank top, they fill the corner here. Okay, under deck area, about 4-5 layer. It depends on the how many tier you will load. For example, you calculate 10 tier. Okay, 5. At first shift, they put 5 here, 5 here, and then they fill the pool, and then second 5 here, second 5 here, and then they fill the pool. Okay, this is the, for example, you will load 12. Okay, 6, 6, 6, 6, and then pull, pull. For example, 8, okay, 4 tier, 4 tier, 4 tier, 4 tier, fill the pool, 4 tier, 4 tier, they just, when they level the cargo, they just, you see, they put the platings and then continue the other. 4, okay. Fill the pool of the inside the cargo hold. Don't forget this one. So, what is the problem here? In some of the vessel, you know, this hatch coming underside the cross decks like this. For example, this is my hatch coming. This is my cargo hold, okay. Some of the vessel cargo hatch coming, the cross deck area very big, very long. And then they put the bulldozer, okay, the first four, for example, let's say 5 here, 5 tier, okay, I fill the pool. Okay, I put this plating again here on the top of the cargo. Okay, I fill the other one. Other five, other five. Okay, I feel the pull. But here some of the vessel distance is very close. You know, here is some feeder hole. I explain in the grain loading video. There is a some plating coming here, so this bulldozer cannot go here. Also, you know, some device, they just make long as much as possible. They just try to put here, for example, some of the port, they make at first, for example, you will load totally, let's say 12 tier, okay. So in the beginning, they just put 4 here, okay, or 5 here, and then make level. In the second time, they put 7 here. Because if this distance very, if they make the level of the cargo very high, the bulldozer or the device cannot work inside, okay. They just make the first layer not very high. And then in the second shift, they just, by the bulldozer, they just put here, okay, as much as possible they load, and then they just fill the pool. Sometimes they make like this. This is my cargo hold. Okay. They just make the one shift. The second shift, they just put here like this. Okay, and then fill the pool here. Fill the pool. And then with the bulldozer, they can come like this here. Some of the vessel not available to work inside the cargo hold. Okay, and then remaining, here is gap. Some cargo loss, correct. And then they just try to complete by here. Also, don't forget, for this wire rodding coil, if it is rod. Okay, what does it mean, the rod? I have already show you. I will show in the pictures, but yesterday in the documents, I have show you. It is a wire. It is a wire, but thick wire, okay, like this. But it don't have scratch on the surface, okay. What is the purpose of this one? They just make it with the nail, some small wire, they just make this one. But if it is deformed bar in coil, if it has some scratch on the surface, it means they use in the this one, in the ship building, okay. For the building flats, something, they are making houses for this purpose. So if it is have scratch, okay, on the surface, it is stronger. For example, you can make here from the tank top to top of the cargo hold, for example, 12 tier, up to 12 tier you can make. But for the wire rodding coil, there is no scratch. It is not very strong. So they generally make 11. 10 to 11 for the deformed in coil, 11 to 12, maximum 13. For example, if you tell them, okay, I have some gap. I have some gap here. So here, for example, total, you load the cargo level, okay, until there already 12 tier. So here some remaining cargo here. Okay, you tell them, okay, I will make here 3 rows, so it will be total 15 tier. Maybe port and the shipper will not allow this one. They will tell you, give me some guarantee letter for this one, because if you load too much high, this cargo, you know, here for it will be like this. When you load too much, on the tank top cargo will be deformed. It will be damaged. So what I mean, when you are preparing, if your company normally cannot ask the vessel, okay, you prepare the stowage plan. Why? Because you don't know everything, okay. You must know the packing list. You must know the load list. You must know how they will load. I have already draw here. Okay, in somehow you have already load very high. For example, this is my cargo hold. Okay, this is forward, this is aft. Okay, somehow any method. Okay, the loading port is very very good. Okay, they load until there. Okay, very good. They make a perfect loading. Okay, but in the discharging, maybe they don't have this equipment to take the cargo from there. How they will discharge? This is also another problem. So, if the company or anybody insist you too much, how Make exact calculation. Exact calculation. Also, I draw here, for example, whole number 3, 4 or 5. 2, 3 or 4. In the whole number 1, you will have curve. Actually, nobody can... Don't forget, for this wire rod in coil, deformed in coil cargo, in hold number 2, number 4, number 5. If it is a box shape, okay. And what I mean box shape, the tank top is a square, exactly square. Okay. You just calculate by the area of the tank top. Okay. Even if you have hopper, okay, no problem. So how will you calculate? I just tell you. For example, I am looking now from the forward aft direction. Okay. This is my... I just changed the picture. Okay, I just close this picture. This is my tank top. This is my double bottom hopper, correct? This is starboard. This is port side and top side hopper. Top side hopper and the hatch coming, okay. This is starboard, this is port side. Okay, how should you call? This is hold number 3 or hold number, pardon, hold number 2, hold number 4, no important. You know this area. This is the beam of the tank top beam and the length of the tank top. You have to calculate here. You see, here is a... You just calculate from this one. And then you just calculate until here. And then for here another calculation. And then for the hatch coming another calculation. Okay, this is one of the way. From the area you can go. Okay, what is my length? What is my beam? Okay, for this area how many pieces I can load? Okay, you can make this one. Yeah, from here to here. Just how will you calculate? You just take from the middle. Okay, this one. And you don't calculate the volume. Okay, just the area, the middle, because it will, how it will change the shape actually like this, correct? So this volume, the increasing volume will be there. So instead of making a volume calculation in here, pardon, şöyle, you just take the average length. Okay, what is the length here? For example, let's say 4 meter, okay. Take from the 2 meter. Okay. What is the beam here? This one. What is the length? This one. What is the area? Okay. I will take here. For let's say işte 700 pieces I will take here. Okay. The remaining. My battery also finish hiding in the mouse. Remaining just a very. It is already box shape. You can make. But for example in cargo hold number. You can make this calculation, but don't forget, when you come to hopper, if it is very high, what is the tier, how many tier, and also, if they can load underside of the cross decks, it is also another problem here. And, part of the another important thing, okay, this is very very easy actually, if you are a box shape cargo hold, it is almost nothing, just a volume calculation. So, hold number 2, 3 and 4. You will calculate from the area. But hole number 5 and hole number 1, you must calculate from the volume. Open the your stability booklet, check the cargo hold volume, for the not net volume. What was the name? It is very late. I am sorry. The bale capacity, volume. Okay. Check the bale capacity. What is the volume? This one. Okay. So, how will you calculate? For example, what I told you, wire rod in coil, it is something like this, okay. So, it is actually, it is about always 2 ton, okay. What is the diameter? The diameter is generally 1.35 something like this, okay. What is the length? The length is 1.5 something like this. So, what is the volume of this one? The cylindric volume you can calculate, okay. So one volume is this one. So total how many? But don't forget this one when you are calculating the volume. Don't forget this one like a box, okay. Don't assume this one. Why? Because when you load the coil like this, you know. So the other coil will come little inside this one. So when you are calculating the height, for example, this is the tank top cargo hold going like this. So how many meters it will increase from here? Exactly the diameter? No, because one coil here, one coil here, the other one, they are not loading like this. They put here, correct? So some distance go between each other, so the height will be reduced. Okay, several things you have to consider this one. And these calculations not same like, okay, they told you you will load coal cargo, işte bulk cargo, grain. Not, you cannot make very fast this one. You have to calculate very carefully. If you are calculating first time, it will take too much time also. Okay. You have to be very careful and you have to know plenty things. Okay. I repeat again. I will just repeat again in the next videos, but you just know what you are doing. Because not all of the company are same. Okay, always some troublemaker people in the company, on the vessel, on the shore, everything, everywhere. Always some kind of peoples. They will force you, they will press you, they will push you. Okay, calculate, calculate, calculate. So, okay, if you want calculation, tell me the packing list. You must give me this one. Tell me the load list. Which cargo will be discharged? Which cargo? Which port? You must tell me how they will load. What kind of method? Which devices they will load and which devices they will discharge. Okay. And also you should know which cargo is, for example, sensitive to rain. Which cargo is not. You have to know several things if you make some calculations. Okay. And I just want to talk about my story about this one. I was chief mate in one of the vessels. The company send us a voyage instruction. İşte you will load steel products. Actually it was a mixed steel products. Anyway, some steel sheets, some cold rolled, some hot rolled. Okay, I have never made this calculation before. Actually, we don't have too much time also for this one. But in the port, they just hire a super cargo. But super cargo not worked on board. He was not a captain. They just tell, okay, we can make this one. They take the money. They come to vessel, but there is no cargo plan, nothing. Actually, before come here, because normally if they attend you super cargo, super cargo make the calculation and send the vessel if you confirm or not confirm. Okay, I will also explain about the which points you should keep in mind if they normally send you the cargo plan. So what points you have to consider, it's important. Okay, anyway, I just make the calculation. Actually it took me about 12 hours something to make this one by one. Okay, so what I want to tell you, some kind of rulers. It is like this. It is like a star, like this. Okay, some kind of rulers, but it has scaled. For example, here is green color. It is like this. One divided 100 times smaller. For example, here 100. 50. You turn the other side, it is 100, 1 to 200. İşte 1 to 250. It is going like this. So you can directly put on the drawings. For example, general arrangement, what is the scale? It's right in here, the scale. For example, they just make a small 1 to 25, 250. Okay, you just used here. One by one, each cargo hold, I make this one. Okay, so actually, I asked them the packing this something. Okay, they just know, but I was not a surveyor. I don't know that much business before because the load nothing. I didn't ask them anything. What is the loading method? What is the discharging method? Actually, it is not an easy thing. Okay, you should have some experience about this one. Okay, some of cargo is easy. For example, if your vessel is box shape, okay, All the steel coils are same size. Okay, very very important. Don't think, just proceed. Just make the calculation from area. But if you are in a bulk carrier with the mixed steel products, actually it is not your business. Okay. Don't forget this one. Yeah, for this video, I think it is enough. It is too late actually. Anyway, I will just continue easy. Each day I will continue about this steel loading. And also, yeah, normally I can show some of the calculations, but you know, I don't want to show the ship name, because in this document, plenty information written, the ship specifications, receiver, company, everything. So I cannot show this one. I am sorry, but I will. I can fix in your mind this how you will make the calculations. But you. What is the important points? Okay. But when they come, and one of the other thing, even if you prepare the stowage plan, for example, don't forget this one. You just prepare the stowage plan. Okay. You will load both cold rolled and hot rolled. Okay. They send you the packing list. This is also another thing. Okay. They send you the load. Everything, whatever you want, they send you. Okay. But what is the another problem here is when you arrive the loading port, okay, you will tell them, okay, at first I want this size of coils in hold number 3, for example. They cannot, I have only see in one port, this one. They can make this one because generally the steel product port very close the factory. And this factory taking several orders, not only your vessel, okay. At the same time, they are fabricating several coils, several different sizes. So, you don't know about their process of production. So, which coils first, which coils last? Maybe your half of the cargo ready. Maybe just 2,000 tons ready, you know. And this 2,000, for example, you should put in the middle in your according to your plan. But the remaining cargo for the cargo is not fabricated yet. So what should you do? Actually, okay, even if, for example, if I go to vessel, I work as a surveyor more than about 2 years I work, okay. So even if I go, even if I go to vessel, even if somebody ask me, at first I will ask you, okay, I will prepare, but when I order the cargo, if they can send me or they cannot send me. It is another problem, you know. Even if you make your plan perfect, but when you order the cargo, if the terminal cannot send you, it is another problem. So, if normally, what does it mean? If somebody insists you to make the plan, actually, he don't know the business. Okay. Why they send you super cargo? Because super cargo is a local guy. Most probably have some relations with the terminal, with the factory. So normally from one of the terminal guy, they have to make the plan together with the terminal. Because terminal can also super cargo cannot know which cargo they are now fabricating, which one is in process, which one is not in process, which one is ready, which one is not ready, which one will become ready, he cannot know also. Actually, it is a cooperation. Okay. Don't forget this one. If they ask you, just relax. Okay. What I recommend you, just relax. What will happen, happen. Actually, on board, as a on board, for the steel product cargo, don't shake your hands, okay? Don't panic, just relax. Because too much things, okay? Actually, nobody knows exactly what will happen. Because even if sometimes terminal guys also, they are making plan but have some problem. Sometimes change of the plan with another vessel, with the ETA, some problem with the vessel, vessel cannot depart. Some vessel have problem, cannot arrive. So the production also changing, everything changing, okay. So this is the second video. Thank you very much for watching. See you.